Okay, and this is the first time the Bull in a China Shop podcast is being videoed while we're taping the podcast. So, technically, I'm not sure how this is going to go. First time I'm running a camera, really. It's not really a camera, it's my iPad. But first time we're running a recording and the podcast at the same time. So, bear with me on that. For everybody who hasn't seen the podcast flying around my page or the Bull in a China Shop website, this is the Bull in a China Shop podcast. I'm Ty Lumley. I'm an ABKC judge. I've been around dogs since the beginning of time. I feel like since I was born. I've been around American Bully since 2007. So we're creeping up on a decade with the American Bully and about 7 years or 8 years with full support for the ABKC. Now, the Bull in a China Shop podcast and Bull in a China Shop TV is not going to be an exclusive affiliate of any specific registry. We are trying to push this breed to the next level, American bullies, but also just bull breeds in general. We're trying to take it to the next level. We want the public to understand the lifestyle we live as far as showing, owning, breeding, judging, as just everything that bull breeds bring to the table and all the positive things that come along with the lifestyle of owning a bull breed. Now, the video won't be very long, so if you want to listen to the entire podcast, you're going to have to tune in. Now, you can tune in on iTunes. We did get iTunes approval, and you can just go to iTunes to the podcast app, type in Bull in a China Shop, it'll pop right up. Type in the Bull in a China Shop podcast, it'll pop right up. Also, in the description, in the link of the video and of the podcast, in the description, there'll be a few different links. I will have a link to where you can directly subscribe to the podcast only by pushing one button. So stay tuned, tune in every week. Sometimes, this shit might not be what you want to hear. If you're not interested that week, I will have different guests. If you don't, this is the first time I'm rolling solo on the podcast also. So if you're not interested in listening to me just talk to myself, that's fine. I will have guests on. If not this week, it'll be next week. The biggest purpose behind this, the biggest reason why I'm doing this, why I created bullinachinashop.com, why I created Bull in a China Top in a China Top, Bull in a China Shop TV, and the biggest reason I created the Bull in a China Shop podcast is because there's too many people out there putting information out there like they're a main source. Like, there's too many people that don't know what the fuck they're talking about trying to tell the general public about our dogs and about bull breeds. See three episodes, you never see the shit again. It's not gonna be that. That's not what I want it to be. I want it to be something that I want it to be almost a peek into the lifestyle that comes along with owning bull breeds. So stay tuned. Pick up the episodes. New the first there's been three episodes already. The first three episodes are already on iTunes. If you don't have an Apple phone, it's okay. I have a link for you also to where you can just click that link, listen to it on your Samsung, Android, all these other whatever device you have, we can get you a link to be able to listen to the podcast. Be a couple little clips. It's not gonna be the whole thing. It's gonna be a couple little clips of basically just me talking, and I don't want to put 45 minutes of a video of just me talking up there. Nobody wants to see my fucking face for 45 minutes. I don't even want to see my face 45 minutes, and I love me. So iTunes approval, but we got it. I don't give a fuck about all the other thing, all the other stuff. We got it. We got the approval from iTunes. The reason why that's such a big deal is iTunes podcast audience reach is about 1 billion people, okay? That's a lot of fucking people. 1 billion, that's a B. That's a billion with a B, not like, and it's a B. After A comes B for billionaire, okay? Billion. It's all the same. You see what I'm saying? That's a lot. If you're a billionaire, you're rich as fuck. iTunes is what we like to call audience rich as fuck. It's got a billion, over a billion reach, or just about a billion reach. Every Apple device comes with a podcast app automatically installed in your device. You don't have to do anything but hit, touch that app, and type in the search area, the Bull in a China Shop podcast, and you will be able to find us at the click of a button. So, and everybody that's watched so far, we've got about 5,000 downloads just over 2.5 weeks. Now, I was expecting around 1,000 downloads per episode, so we're leaps and bounds ahead of where we thought we'd be, or I thought I'd be at this point, with just releasing everything and nobody really knowing what we've got going on and what the purpose. Already, we're seeing massive amount of people, large number of people that are looking for a source of information to help them and a little bit of entertainment value also. Now, I'm not the funniest guy on the planet. I'm not the prettiest guy on the planet. I wouldn't want to look at me or listen to me for hours and hours and hours, but we're only doing this 1 hour a week. Eventually, we're going to expand it to 2 hours a week. Right now, it's one podcast a week, and it's going to be less than an hour. So it's going to be between 45 minutes and an hour. So for an hour of your week. Now, I know everybody that has more than two dogs spends probably close to an hour a week at least scooping dog shit out of their kennels or out of the yard or walking your pet, rescue animal, whatever the case may be, walking your dogs that you're breeding, whatever the case may be. For 45 minutes a week, or an hour a week, there's no better place for you to be than the Bull in a China Shop podcast. There's nothing better for you to be listening to if you want what you're doing to have more success.